It's very easy and convenient to run your apps on containers, whether it's for application development or on cloud environments. But imagine working with a more complex application that requires multiple services. It would be a nightmare having to manually run all these containers every time you restart your system. Lucky for us, Docker provides restart policies to control whether your containers should restart automatically when they exit or when Docker restarts. You can use restart policies to always run a container as a service for local development. For example, you can start a Redis database as soon as you start up your laptop. Or maybe with something more elaborate, like making sure a container that runs a vital service for your team is restarted automatically on failure. To configure a restart policy, you use the --restart flag, together with the Docker run or Docker update command. So what restart policies are available on Docker? The default for any new container is no. If it stops for any reason, it will remain stopped until it's manually restarted. On failure, this option will auto-restart a container that terminates with a non-zero exit code. We'll see an example of that later in the video. The always option restarts containers when they fail or the Docker daemon itself is restarted. The unless stopped option works the same way as the always, except if a container is manually stopped, it will not auto-start again after a Docker or system restart. But enough with the talking, and let's see how it works in practice. We're now going to set a restart policy for new and running containers, and in the process, test out all the different options. Make sure you follow along until the end of the video, because I'm going to show you how to easily simulate a failing container and make sure Docker restarts it automatically. Let's spin up a new Redis database and make sure it is always running on our laptop. Docker run. Let's give it a name, like demo-redis, -d to run it in the background, and use the --restart flag with the always option. Expose the Redis port 6379, container is Redis, and hit enter. We can see with docker-ps that the container is running. I will now restart the Docker daemon manually and verify the container will still be running after that. Docker-ps again, and our demo, Redis, has been restarted automatically by Docker. Another interesting thing to know is that restart policies can be updated on existing and running containers. Let's change the policy for demo Redis. Docker, container, update, --restart, and let's use the unless stopped this time. This option will act the same way as the always option, with the exception that if we stop the container manually, it will not attempt an auto-restart. Final argument is the container name, demo-redis, and hit enter. I'm now stopping the container, restart Docker, and speed it up to see the effect of the unless stopped option. For day-to-day use of restart policies, I like the unless stopped option more. I don't always work with the same project every day, so if for some reason I don't need a container for a while, I can just stop it manually, and it will remain stopped until I need it again. Now, as promised, we're going to simulate a failing container and see how the onFailure policy works. If you're liking this video so far, I would really appreciate you letting me know with a like or by leaving a comment below. We know a failing container for Docker is a container that exits with a non-zero status code. So we can run my personal favorite Linux Alpine and make it sleep for 10 seconds, then exit with an error code. Docker run, -d to run in the background, --name, failing demo, Alpine, and chain these two commands. Sleep 10, exit 1. And as expected, after 10 seconds, the container exited with an error code. You can see this by the exited 1 in the status column, where 1 is the exit code. As a final step, we update the restart policy. Docker container update restart equal to onFailure, failing demo. And you can see now the container keeps restarting every 10 seconds. I hope this video on Docker's restart policies will help you managing your containers with ease. If you have any questions or feedbacks, please leave a comment below, and if you found this content useful, I'd really appreciate a like. Don't forget to subscribe if you'd like to learn more about Docker and containers. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.